Howdy, I am RK, and this is Game Endeavor. Slowing time is effective when you want to emphasize an attack. It adds an extra layer of polish to your games, and also serves as more feedback to the player. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to implement a slow time effect in your Godot games, which I will be using whenever the player takes damage. Let's go ahead and get started. We're going to be adjusting the engine's timescale to achieve the slow motion effect. This will adjust the rate of the in-game clock, which will affect things such as timers, tweens, and the delta parameters of the process methods. This means we will not be able to use a tween node effectively, so we're going to have to do our own easing calculations. To do this, we're going to need to store a few variables. Once we change the engine's timescale, we're always going to ease back to 1, so for readability, I will create a constant named invalue and set it as 1. We will be using the process method for our easing logic, but we only want it to process whenever the effect is active. So we'll create a Boolean variable called isActive, which we will use to check for this. I will go ahead and set it to false. We also need to know when we started the tweening and how long it's going to last for. So I'll create two variables, one named timeStart and the other durationMS. We'll be working in milliseconds, hence the MS. And finally, we need to know what the time scale was when we started the easing. This will be what we set it to when the effect starts and will determine the strength of the effect. I will store this in a variable named startValue. We'll begin by creating the start method. This is what we'll call whenever we want to initiate the effect. It'll need two parameters, duration being the time that the effect will last in seconds, and strength being a value between 0 and 1, which will determine what we set the engine's timescale to before easing back to normal speed. The main purpose of the start method is to store some information we'll need for the tweening and then initiate the effect. So first, we'll get the current number of milliseconds that have passed since the game was launched by calling the method os.getticksmsec, and then store this in our time start variable. We will use this later to determine how long the effect has been running. Since we're working in milliseconds, we'll translate the duration variable to milliseconds by multiplying it by 1000 and then storing it in our durationMS variable. And then we'll set the start value to 1 minus strength. I do these translations for simplicity's sake when you're calling these methods from outside of the script. It makes more sense to me to choose the strength rather than choosing what to set the time scale to. But this is a personal preference of mine. Feel free to do whatever is comfortable to you. And then, to initiate the effect, we'll set engine.timescale to our value immediately. This will give the effect of the game slowing instantly, which will be what adds emphasis if you're using this to convey impact. And then we'll set isActive to true, so it knows to do our easing logic in our process method. And that is it for our start method. Now we need to handle the processing logic, so we'll create our process method, and in it, we'll use an if statement to check if isActive is true. If it is, then we'll get the current time by subtracting timeStart from another call to os.getticksmsec. And store it in a variable named currentTime. And with this, we have all the information we need to create our own easing function. I've included two links in the description, one to a page full of easing equations and another to a cheat sheet that shows you how tweens look, the latter being extremely useful in general. I reference it all the time. Feel free to browse these and find whichever tween you would like to use for this effect. I will be using an ease in with a circular transition. To me, this tween goes great with this effect because it has a long hang time, which will provide plenty of emphasis and allow the player a moment to think and plan, and then suddenly it snaps back to the end value. With this decided, we'll go ahead and create a method to process the equation. It will need the current time, the start time, the end value, and the duration, which for simplicity's sake we will refer to as T, B, C, and D as it is on the equation site. And to spare you the horrors of listening to me trying to read this equation, I'll leave it up for you to read on your own. And with that done, we'll return to our process method and make a call to our easing function, giving it the variables that it needs, and storing the result in a variable named value. And right quick, before setting the timescale, we're going to make a check to see if current time is greater than or equal to durationMS. If it is, then the effect is ended, so we will need to set isActive to false. We also need to make sure that the timescale returns to normal, so we will set value to inValue. And finally, we will set engine.timescale to value. With this done, we simply make a call to the start method anywhere within our game. I will be connecting my player's damage signal directly to the start method as demonstrated here. You could always use this with a lesser strength value whenever the player damages an enemy. This is sometimes done in shooter games to make the player feel more powerful. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then be sure to join the sub club and let me know what you thought. I post a new video at least once a week, so be sure to come back. There are links to my Twitter and Discord in the description below if you're interested. I would love to hear from you, whether it be feedback, suggestions, or topics you would like for me to cover in the future. And until next time, y'all take it easy.